Lower down. So. Sarika, what's all right, Assalamualaikum, Brother Jim. Here we go. Assalamualaikum. All right, everyone. Let us begin with our Fatiha for these few minutes we have left, inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Rahmanir Rahim. Malik Yawm al-Din. Yakin mudu yakin nasta'in. Inna sirata mustaqim. Sirata al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. Ghayril maghdubi alayhim. Wal-dhalin. Amin. All right. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Again, we were working in Surah Ali Imran, Surah 3. We were on Ayat. Let's go to Ayat 40, inshallah. Let's see. Peter's acting a little bit slow this morning. I'm sorry. Okay, let's inshallah. Let's start Ayah 30. I'm sorry. Ayah 30. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Allah says, Yoma Hajidu Kula Nafsin Ma Amilat Min Khair Muhdaratan Muhdara Wa Ma Amilat Min Suin Tawaddu No and Bainaha wa Bainahu Amadan Baidan wa Yah wa Yu Hadiruhu Yurukum Allah Nefsahu Wallahu Raufan Bil Ibad Yom the day on the day Tajidu from Wajada to find Tajidu will find Kula Nefsin, every soul. Again, it was the Tajidah because the Nefs is feminine. So it's Tajidu, I'm sorry. Yoma Tajidu, Kula Nefsin, Ma Amilet. Everything that the soul, Ma, what it did. Amilet, from Amalat, to do, to work. Ma Amilet, Min Khair. Everything that it did, Min Khair, everything that it did of good. Had Moh Madaratan presented. Moh Daran, meaning it'll be presented to it. All the good will be presented to that soul. Wa ma amilat mensu and whatever it did of bad. Wa ma amilat. Again, it's feminine, so it's not amala. Amilat mensu and the what do? It will wish. What do? It will wish. Lo anna bainaha wa bainahu. Amadan by Eden. And it will wish that all, talking about the bad now, it will wish, to what do it will wish, if that, if, and bainaha, bain it itself, bainaha, because the soul is feminine, so it gets the ha, between it, or between her, wa bainahu, and between it, the evil, the bad, amadan, a distance by Eden, a far distance. Why you the hero kumu Allah nafsuhu, and well you the hero kumu Allah, and you are being warned. You all are being warned. You are being warned by Allah nafsuhu himself. Allah warns us himself. Wallahu Raufun Billy Bad. Allah is so compassionate, most merciful and compassionate for his to his servants, with his servants, Billy Bad. Again, Yoma Tajidu Kula Nefsin Ma Amilet Min Khairin Muhdurin Wa Ma Amilet Min Su'in. All the good and the bad, it will be presented to it. The what do, and it will wish it, that if that bainaha, between itself, between bainaha, its nafs, but bainahu, and between its evil, amadan by Eden, a far distance, a distance far. Why you had there a hukumu Allah, and Allah warned you himself, nafsuhu, Allahu Raouf and Billy Bad. Cool. In kuntum tuhibuna Allah, fa etabuni, fatabiuni, then follow me. You hibkumu Allah. Yuhibkumu Allah. Will love you Allah. Wayakfir lakum thunubakum. Wallahu ghafur rahim. Again, it's very clear. Allah makes it so clear. Say, in kuntum tuhibun Allah. If you love Allah, then follow me. Ba. Fataba means to follow. Fa means so. Fatabilni. Yuhibkumu Allah. Allah will love you. Nubakum. Your sins. And Allah is a Ghafurun, all forgiving.
Ar-Rahim, most merciful. Very simple and clear. Say, Atiyu Allah wa Rasuluhu. Say, obey Allah and His Messenger and the Messenger. Fa'inna tawallo, and if they turn away, fa'inna Allah la yuhibbu al kafirin. Say, obey Allah and His Messenger. So a prophet, say, O prophet, tell him, O Muhammad, that if you should obey Allah and the prophet, and if you And if they turn away, then know, for surely, for the know is understood, then know surely that Allah does not love the kafirin. Inna Allah astafa Adama wa Nuhan and Noah wa Ali Ibrahim wa Ali Ibrahim wa Ali Imran Alal Alameen. Inna Allah astafa. He chose Adam, wa Nuhan, wa Ali Ibrahim, wa Ali Imrana, Alal Alameen. And know that Allah chose Inna. Allah, surely Allah chose Adam and Noah and the family of Ibrahim, or the family of Imran, Allah over all the worlds, all of the peoples of the world. Again, indeed Allah chose, translation, indeed Allah chose Adam, Noah, the family of Ibrahim, the family of Imran, above all people of their time. The Riyatun, descendants, Badaha Minbad. The Riyatin Baduha Minbad. One upon another. Or descendants one of another. One descendants, one coming after the other. One generation of descendants followed after another. Baduha Minbad. Wallahu Samiyun Alim. And Allah is all hearing. Oh, no. If Kalati, Imratu, Imrani, Rabi, any Nathurtu, Leka, Mafi, Butni, I'm sorry, Mahararan, for Kabbalah, Mini. So it's so, except for me. Innaka anta asamiyu alim. If kalat imratu imrane. Said imratu, the wife of Imran. Rabbi, my lord, inni nadartu. I have vowed leka to you. Mafi butni, what is in my womb, muharran, dedicated. But takabul minni, so please accept it of me. Innaka, surely you, innaka anta asami'ul alim. Surely you are of the all-hearing, the all-knowing. And the time is short this morning. We had technical difficulties, but inshallah, we will have gotten something from today's lesson. And inshallah, we'll have it sorted out, inshallah, for next week. Inshallah, we'll close today, this morning, with Al-Fatiha. We'll bring on Brother Imam Raouf for the Taleem for this morning. Let's close out with Al-Fatiha. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Rahmanir Rahim. Malik Yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'een. إذن أسرعت ومستكين أسرعت على الدين ونمت عليهم أعر المغضوب عليهم والدولين آمين Thank you everyone
آمين وعليكم السلام إمام A little surprised when I logged in to hear you can y'all hear me?
Yes sir, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I said I was a little surprised when I logged in that you were on.
Yeah, well I mean it's kind of, I don't know.
I was surprised because I when I left things, we said that you weren't going to be on this week.
Well, I tried, and it's still kind of confusing. I'm on a different computer, and I'm trying to. They wanted me to change my password and my login, and it's almost like it's this really, you know. But inshallah, I'm trying to get back to my original computer. That's why it's easiest. But on this other computer, it's not working too well.
Well, I'm sorry I missed you, but I think
I was just these last 15 minutes. That's all. You didn't miss much. It was just these last few minutes.
Okay. I was going to say that people tell me that all the time, but when it comes to your class, I don't miss much.
Okay. Oh, man. Okay, brother, ma'am, you're being recorded. We're being recorded. It's all good, brother, ma'am. You're in the wrong profession.
I couldn't resist that one. I tried to resist it.
Alhamdulillah, it's all good. Thank you so much.
Listen, thank you, Imam, for persisting. Like I said, I don't want to miss any of your class, and so I thank Allah that you were able to get on. I just wish I had been there for it, but alhamdulillah, it's recorded and I can get it.
Yes. Go ahead.
When we're going to hear from you, when you're giving the khutbah at Ali Khan, I know you're always available for the nation's mosque, but when are you coming to the Ali Khan Islamic Center?
Give me a couple of weeks. This tomorrow I'm going out of town on a hiking trip with my sons, and then so I won't be back until like Thursday evening. But are we supposed to be going to Colorado and do still go hiking? Man, I mean, it's the first time, and so inshallah, hopefully I can make it.
Inshallah,
a couple of day hiking. So inshallah.
Well, all I can say is that it warms my heart to know that you and the boys, are hanging out.
That's right. That's right. Alhamdulillah.
All three of your sons?
No, my one in Germany is not, just my two here.
Okay.
Not the one all in right. Germany. Alhamdulillah.
Well, you all have a wonderful time. That brings us to our Taleem. We'll open up with Al-Fatiha. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. He Maliki Yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdina siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladhina an'amta 'alayhim. Ghayril maghdubi 'alayhim wa ad-dallin. I mean, now, what is the role of Islam in America / the world today? What is our role? Well, the short answer is our role is to carry out the mission of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to establish Islamic community life and to promote the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, promote human decency, and to establish righteousness, build strong families, and combat the strategies of Shaitan, who seeks to weaken love and respect and obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most glorious and the most high and the only deity. No deity except Allah. Allah is alone. So that is the big picture of what our role is. The question is, where do we fit in 2023? You've got the Democrats who have been taken over by the Pride Mafia. Y'all know who the Pride Mafia is?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You got the Democrats who go for anything, open to everything. And the question is, do we align ourselves with the Democrats, even though they you know, they're open for everything and anything, and seem to have no real standards, or do we go with the Republicans, who are the promoters of white supremacy, who claim to have values, but have no values, and are simply trying to resurrect white supremacy in a country that's moving in a different direction. That is our America. And then we look at these fringe people. It appears that the Republicans have also resurrected an old strategy that they've had before, and that is to split the African American vote by running these fringe candidates. One is this, what's the name of that professor? Cornel West?
Yeah, Cornel West, yes, sir.
So Cornel West is running for president. Is that right?
Yes, he's a People's Party, yes, sir.
Okay. Cornel West is running for president. Why is Cornel West running for president? To take away the black vote. To get Donald Trump elected. So Cornel West is working for Donald Trump. And then we have Kanye West. He's running for something, we don't know. But why would he be running? To get Donald Trump elected. And there are going to be others. So this is a strategy that is being used and if the Democrats got any brains, they better get somebody to run as a Republican distractor to counteract the moves that the Republicans are making against them. All right, so again, this is the topic of this Taleem. What is the role of Muslims? Are we with the Democrats? Are we with the Republicans? Are we going to start a Islam party? The party of the Tablighi party? Remember, Jeffrey, what do you think about that?
I don't know.
The Tablighi party. Everybody's got to, you know, wear a white robe who's in the party.
Right.
And we got to swear allegiance to the 12th Imam or something. No, of course I'm kidding with that. Now, do we want Donald Trump as president? Anybody?
No, sir.
I was going to say hell no, but we don't want Donald Trump as president. We know why. I don't have to tell you why. Nor do we want his alter ego, Ron DeSantis. I could live with Chris Christie. You know, I can't live with many others because they're so weak. But Chris Christie has backbone, and he has, you know, he's an intelligent person. I think he'd make a hell of a president. Personally, I'm going with Joe Biden because I have pride. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. You can't make this stuff up.
Yeah.
We are not against the homosexuals, per se. We're not against, you know, in the sense that they are Americans, they have civil rights. But we are not going to stand by and promote homosexuality.
That's right.
Because we have children. And our children are our sacred trust. They're what Allah has given us as a reward for being human. He's given us children.
That's right.
And we don't want our children confused about the benefits of being a man, the benefits of being a woman. These are things that Allah has established that are good, the male and the female. Once you start tinkering with the human identity, we're lost. We are lost. We are lost in space. And like I said, we don't want open criminals in the White House because the country's going to run fine. But the damage that we've done will be long lasting. So, this is a great time. It's the Hajj season. The Hajj season. The Hajj is important. It's important.
I'll be back for in a second, brother. Then 1 second.
Sir. Yes, sir. The Hajj is important. But human dignity is more important. And we have a fight on our hands. Let's not give in to emotionalism and vote for Cornel West. Who apparently is okay with working for Donald Trump. I remember when the Honorable Thurgood Marshall did not step down. And I think it was the presidency of Bill Clinton. He could have resigned from the Supreme Court. No, but he sat there, stayed there, and died in office and gave Bush an appointment for another right-wing jurist to be appointed. So, you know, sometimes we have to look beyond our personal circumstances and look for what's beneficial for the whole of humanity. So, our life and our death of the whole human race is like the life and the death of a single soul. What we do individually can have a great impact on the group. And so, Muslims, we have to work for the good. We have to work for the future. We're working for the future. Live as if you're going to die today, but also live as if you're going to live forever. So we're working for establishing institutions locally that are going to benefit our children in the future. My personal children are grown. But I also, the children that are coming, my grands and great-grands, I'm working for them to establish something for them. That's our duty. That's our responsibility. We can't we can't remain on the sidelines during the debate in society about homosexuality. And please, dear believers, you can't go to people and say, well, the homosexuals, they're going to get their book behind their back. They're going to get their book upside down. They're going to get their book in their left hand. What does that mean? Virtually nothing. Until you make it understandable. Homosexuality is a rejection of what is natural. A rejection of what is organic, what is best, what is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained. Well, you say, oh, I don't believe in Allah. Well, you believe in being organic, you believe in being natural. Although Allah created the organs and the organisms and created nature. But moving away from, okay, we're not even going to go into the issue of your belief or non-belief in Allah, though Allah is the only reality. Homosexuality is unnatural. And so we're not going to promote it. We can't. We're going to promote male-female relationships, normal, healthy relationships. We don't want to promote anything that you characterize as queer. There's no such thing as bisexual. You're one or the other. And you're at the organic level, at that biological level. Either XX, which is female, or XY, which is male. There's no confusion. Stop trying to bring up, oh, the hermaphrodites. There may be some people that have certain deficiencies or abnormalities, but we don't need to make a category for that. That is not a part of the rule. That's an exception to the rule. And we promote what is healthy and good. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the best knowledge. He's the author of the male and the female. He's the author of the night and the day, the up and the down. We don't want to be unclear about our position. We follow what Allah has ordained. And we recognize that some people are not going to fall into those categories. But those are people, in its essence, are considered deviants. But they're human. They have rights of human beings. They have right to work, to live. So, but we're not going to promote that lifestyle any more than we're going to promote any other unhealthy, unnatural lifestyle. We want to protect our children from these male pedophiles. I mean, even in sports, we don't want no men competing in women's sports. That's unfair. And it shouldn't take a lot of brain power to understand the unfairness of that. And so, what is the role of Islam? It's to promote La ilaha illallah. How do we promote La ilaha illallah? We have to first make it clear that the chosen people of the righteous is no chosen race, ethnicity, religion. The chosen are the righteous, and they're chosen by virtue of their excellence in character, in faith to Allah, and the doing of good in this life. Those are the chosen. That's what we have to promote. We have to promote also, and maybe even more importantly, that Allah is the sovereign of all. Allah has no children. Allah has no uncles, no aunts. Allah is not a male. Allah is not a female. Allah has no wife. We can't accept any idea that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a female counterpart. Because you now, by that idea, you're promoting the idea, the concept that Allah is a male. And Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most glorious and most high, is not a male. Those things, male and female, those things really are attributable to the creation, where there you have this these sort of complementary aspects of life, the male, the female, the night and the day, and so forth. But Allah has nothing that's complementary to Allah, because Allah is one. Allah is unique. Allah is alone. And the creation is the tool that he utilizes. And the creation comes in, exists, does greatness, and then it goes out. It ceases to exist. And Allah was with us in existence before this creation, and it was a creation before that, and it will be creations after this one. So our role as believers is to promote healthy thinking in society, because society is grappling with questions about the people of Africa, the people of Australia, the idea of inferiority and superiority among people. We're grappling with these issues. We're grappling with the gender identities. We're grappling with how to treat the poor. What is the responsibility of the developed nations as opposed to the underdeveloped nations? We here in the African American community. The African American community is suffering because of
the shock of enslavement, the inferiority complex that is based in a large part on white supremacy in religion. We have to be honest. The idea of Jesus being Allah, part of a Trinity, is white supremacy. It's white supremacy.
Plain and simple.
So, how can we, you know, I remember as a child hearing about the theology of Black liberation and how good that made me feel. That, you know, that, but you can't take medicine, take poison and add some sugar to it and sell it as a health food. You can't, you, it's still gonna kill. It's just not gonna taste bad.
That's right.
But the worship of Jesus, the Son of Mary, is white supremacy. You say that Allah had a son with a Jewish woman. And that son was Allah. You're insane. That's insanity. Do a little bit of research, just a little bit. Get a red letter Bible. Look at the words that are placed in Jesus' mouth in the red letter Bible. What's a red letter Bible? A red letter Bible is a Bible that has the sayings of Jesus, the statements that are attributed to Jesus the Christ. They put them in red letters. And you read those red letters. You read that book, those books, the red letter Bible. In it, Jesus says, I am not God. I was sent by God.
By God? Ooh.
And he also says, it's expedient that I go away. I have to go away. And you will see me no more. You will see me no more. But when I go away, I will send to you. The Comforter. Now, of course, all this is in Greek. And Jesus didn't speak Greek. He said, I'm going. I got to go. It is required that I go. But after me will come Ahmed. And he will say nothing of himself. He will say only what is revealed to him. Allahu Akbar.
Akbar.
Allahu Akbar. This is what we've been waiting for. This is what the connection. The Quran is what was revealed. It has nothing from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran. The source of Quran is solely Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so here it is in the New Testament. Made plain. But because of the poison, because of the chocolate flavored poison, we don't think, we don't read, we don't understand. and we're bought off. It is so convenient to be a Christian. It is so convenient to join the majority, to worship Jesus. And to ignore what Jesus is reported to have said, according to the red letter Bible, he's going away and you're never going to see him again. You will see me no more. But then we'll see him again. So that's a paradox. But then when we see him again, it won't be the same person. It will be the same role, R-O-L-E. The same role will come back. But not the same individual. You don't come back. Many have died. None have come
back. Ma'am.
Yes. I can't hear you.
That is when it says he will speak none of his own desires. That is 53. I had 53. Surah 53. 53, 3 and 4.
You read it for me?
Nor does he speak of his own whims. It is only a revelation sent down to him. Surah 53, ayahs 3 and 4.
And it's in other places too. That Allah says.
Yes, sir, Alhamdulillah.
It's in other places as well. But we're talking to the people who read the Bible.
Right, it's in right, their that's book. Right. That's right, that's right.
It's in their book. He will say nothing of his own, but only what is revealed to him.
That's right.
This is what Jesus is supposedly said. So this is confirmation that came 500, almost 600 years before the coming of the prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Jesus said this. And Moses said, there will be coming a prophet like me. Oh. And he will come out of Arabia. This is what Moses said. And he would have a great victory with 10,000 saints. What is that? That's the conquest of Mecca, of Mukarramah, by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Was selling. So we are we get all kinds of information to help us understand our role. What is our role as Muslims? We have to be the educators. We gotta put the pieces, the blocks together. We got to point out, look at what this says. Look, now, others have done it. But no one is in a position to educate as well as the students of Imam W. Dean Muhammad. Because Imam W. Dean Muhammad is the son of Clara. And he brought clarification to the message. We get the message and we don't really understand how it's applied. And we get lost, dear believers. We get lost in the weeds. Jesus was born of a virgin. Okay, we can't do anything with that. It goes against science. It goes against nature. Until you get clarification. So Imam Muhammad brings clarification. He's saying this is speaking to how the righteousness is introduced and reintroduced and brought into the world. It has to come out of a virgin. society. A society that has not been corrupted by Shaitan. So, what we're saying is, Jesus' mother was the Essenes. That's the society he came out of. And it was a virgin society because it was unconnected with the corrupt rabbis of that time. These were people who were innocent and pure. Imam Muhammad was born of a virgin. The nation of Islam, in its role in the human rights movement during the Jim Crow era, it was a virgin. And the man came out of that. And he spoke in the cradle. He spoke in the cradle. Again, all these things, you can accept them literally, but they have more power. They have more creative. They have more rejuvenating. They have more elucidating power when you get clarification. Imam Muhammad was the son of Clara. Clara Muhammad. And he had clarification from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our role is we are educators. We're teachers. That's our most important contribution, is to give the people clarification on how to understand the divine message in the Holy Bible, the divine message in the Holy Quran. I said, yes, I said the Holy Bible. Because the Bible is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it needs clarification. And who can give it better than us? Nobody. Because we are the blessed students of the greatest of all the Majeddids, W.D. Muhammad. And so, I don't know what to say. There's so much to say that has been said. But we are going to have to adopt the honorable profession of being educators. That's our role. Yes, we can open up a masjid. We should do that. We need to do that. But we need to write and to speak. And we need to educate in this masjid. We need to teach the people how to apply in your time the Quran, the Holy Quran. So you would know your role. Come in.
You know you've only got 20 minutes.
I'll be finished in 20 minutes because I'm doing my Taleem.
Okay.
Excuse me, y'all. Now, we're not going to have any long-term value if we don't take on our role. We're the educators. Just like Imam Jeffrey is an educator. We are educators. We have to educate the Muslims. We have to educate the Christian. We have to educate the Jews to the correct, proper, appropriate understanding and utilization of the word of Allah and the role and the contribution of the prophets and the, not only the prophets, but the great people. That's in the end that you would know the truth, and the truth would make you free. That's what the Bible says. What does the Holy Quran say? It says, in the end, the people would have a light that went out before them. It's the same thing. Again, you have to be able to understand the message so you can understand your role. Our role is to turn on the light. So the Christians can stop worshiping Jesus and start implementing the role of Christ. And you don't even know what his role is. But we have a sacred, solemn duty to teach the message of Jesus as Muslims. We've been blessed with the insight so we can help the Christians be better Christians. We're not trying to make you Muslim. Only Allah makes Muslims. And the best Christians are good Muslims. Meaning, the good Christian, the essence of the Christians, are the ones who say, my life and my death is all for Allah. And that's what Jesus said. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. What better proof do you need that Jesus was Muslim? So, what are we going to do? We're going to come up with ways and means to disseminate the tafsir of Imam W.D. Muhammad. Alhamdulillah. This is a legacy that's lasting. How many times you made Hajj? How many sunnah prayers you made? How many days of fasting? Those are good things. But when you educate the future and take away Shaitan's ability to manipulate and destroy, that's better. That's greater. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is known not for the things he did, but for what he did to educate the future generations. He preserved the Holy Quran as Allah would have him. He preserved his sunnah. He counseled the people. And that's why Muhammad is the most prevalent name in the whole world. You don't believe me? Google it. Go to Bing. I don't care what search engine you go to. I don't work for Google. But the truth is plain and distinct from error. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. La ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu qayyum. Nothing that should be worshipped except Allah, the ever-living, the eternal, has no need of any of his slaves. So, we have to, you know, we don't tell you who to, we don't represent the Republicans, we don't represent the Democrats. We try, with the help of God, to represent the righteous. Let's educate believers. Start by assigning in your life value to the Arabic studies class by Imam Jeffrey Ali, given every Sunday at 10 a.m. Assign value to that. Attend that. Study Arabic. It's a key to unlocking the Quran. And if you're proficient, you can read some great biographies of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that were never translated into English. And we can read some of the great concordances and the great tafsir. But it is not likely we're going to find a tafsir that equals to, that surpasses or equals the tafsir of Imam W.D. Muhammad. And he came to the ignorant, to the rejected, and his words brought these people back to life. He gave life to the dead by the permission of Allah. And his message, his tafsir, is timeless. It has in it the organic properties to enliven the message in the Bible. And so we should put a great emphasis and weight on it. Support the classes, the Taleem by Imam Raouf Abdullah at 11. Support the Arabic. Come to the Jummah prayer in person or online. Ask questions. What is the Islamic position on homosexuality? Good question. We have, with the help of God, we have answers. What is the Islamic position on domestic violence? Good questions. With the help of God, we have answers. What are we going to do about our youth? Taking drugs, carrying guns, twerking, engaging in premarital sex. Believing that, hey, why work? We can rob and steal. We have a duty to save our youth and protect them and save our families from the fire. Allah has blessed us mightily with this tafsir. We can go into the Holy Quran and bring out all the wonderful food. It's lentils, it's garlics, it's lettuce, all the healthy foods, the spiritual foods, that is. And we can preserve humanity. We are in the business of human salvation. That's how we're going to make it, with the help of Allah. The business of human salvation. That's our role, dear believers. This is the Taleem today. What is the role? The role is to educate people on what is Allah saying in the Quran. What is Allah saying in the Bible? What is Allah saying to us in the natural world? Allah has messages in the natural world. He has messages in our own bodies. And we understand those messages and can make it plain to the people. The Quran is clear, but the environment in that we're in doesn't put the emphasis we need at this time on the message. We have to address, we got to address the disaffection of young people in the culture. The young people are lost. We have to make it clear to them that religion is more than just feelings. It's more than just dancing, feeling good, feeling the spirit. It's more than that. It's developing a pattern of life, of behavior. You can't be free and be out there in the public twerking. We can't be free using drugs, smoking cigarettes, drinking alcohol. Trying to say, I want to sleep with the person of the same sex. I want to try it. Who knows? Maybe I'm trans. I'm confused. We gotta free our people from being lost. So alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. We're gonna take a moment's break. Alhamdulillah, 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 la ilaha illahu ahayu qayyum. The world needs the Muslims to step up and proclaim openly and clearly. Openly and clearly. That's our role. Open. You can't talk in all these languages that people don't understand. Clearly, you gotta break it down to the level of thinking of the Christians. Our role is not to convert people to Islam. Our role is to open up the human potential. Allah will determine who's going to be a Muslim or not. But we have to educate the people and add to their human potential. That's what we have to do. And as the students of Imam Dawdi Muhammad, education, give the people the insight, the understanding. So, I mean, that's, again, this is Taleem. What is our role? We're not going to help put Donald Trump back in the White House. Are you insane? Alhamdulillah, 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 ilaha. Huwa. There's no deity except Allah. That's what the Bible says. This is what the Old Testament says. This is what the New Testament says. But it's not open. It's not plain. It's our duty to open it up and make it plain. That's our duty. We are the teachers for this time. We ain't going to argue with people. We're going to put it out there. And we pray that the ones who Allah is blessing, they'll get it. The rest of them, Allah will decide between us and them. We're not going to fight with you. We trust in Allah. Allah alone. Alhamdulillah. So, I mean, that's the, again, dear believers, that's today's Taleem. What is the role of Muslims? What are we going to do to protect our children from this culture that is seeking to destroy them? Alhamdulillah. Okay, so as we wind down, we are the students of Imam Dawdi Muhammad, who was the son of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And Imam came to open up our eyes to the Holy Quran and to the Prophet and to the role of Jesus and Moses and Abraham, and to give us a way that we can make a lasting contribution. Do yourself a favor and get with this. Alhamdulillah. La ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum.
That's right.
Now, you would say, well, what does that mean? No deity except Allah, the ever living, the eternal. That's what it means. Great blessing from God. Open up our eyes. Let us benefit from this life. Don't just live for yourself. Live for humanity. Live for the future, dear believers. Alhamdulillah. Thank you. I greet you and close out with Al-Fatiha. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Maliki yawm al-deen. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. So we thank you. It's now noon. We're gonna go hit the club.
Don't do it, brother.
Not today. No, we're gonna, with the help of Allah, we're gonna go out and educate.
Yes, sir.
About this great news. This great news.
That's right.
Of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. The Quran. It is human salvation.
That's right.
And so thank you, Imam Jeffrey. We appreciate you hanging in there with us this hour. And we pray that this broadcast does some good. And we pray that we see you all next week for the Arabic class at 10 a.m. on Sunday, to be followed at 11 by the Taleem. Assalamu alaikum, dear brother Leaves.
Assalamu alaikum, alhamdulillah. Have a good day, brother. Bye-bye.
그것도 뭐 손다구 약 먹고 하면 금방 내려가고. 아무튼 그런 거 아니에요. 아무 무슨.
저 어머니.
아니, 검사 제대로 한거 맞아요? 거기 진영순 제 이름 맞냐고요. 아니, 그게 중요한 게 아니고. 실은. 아니, 그게 중요한 게 아니고.
저 어머니.
아니, 검사 제대로 한거 맞아요? 거기 진영순 제 이름 맞냐고요. 아니, 그게 중요한 게 아니고. 실은 우리 아들이 지금 많이 아프거든요. 그러니까 제가 이런 선생님 살려주세요. 이거 수술하면 낫는 거 맞죠? 그쵸? 이거 얼마 전에 뉴스에 보니까 막 이제 말기암도 고치는 신약이 나왔다고 막 그러는데. 제가 말도 잘 듣고 치료도 열심히 받을게요. 그럼 제가 진짜로 선생님 제가 진짜로 죽으면 안 돼요. 선생님 우리 아들 강호.
기운 내야지. 네가 쓰러지면 어떡해? 일어나. 넌 엄마잖아.